What's up, you data friends? It's Yanis here and welcome to my channel. In this video, we're going to be comparing the data analyst job versus the data scientist job. And more specifically, we're going to touch on their day-to-day tasks, their skills, and their tools needed in their job. I have also created a few examples here into Power BI, where I analyze the day-to-day tasks and the technologies used by each role, so you can get a visual representation. And I have also created a few examples into SQL, Python, Power BI, and Excel in order to help you gain a better understanding of these two roles. Okay, so starting from the job descriptions now, a data analyst collects, analyzes, and reports data so the business can gain a better understanding of their performance. The data scientist now analyzes data sets using a variety of tools and sophisticated techniques in order to solve business problems and generate actionable insights that will add value to the business and make an impact. So the difference between these two is actually that the data scientist is using a variety of tools and also sophisticated techniques, which are the machine learning models, which we will touch later on. But we will take this step by step so you can see that a lot of the tasks that the data analyst is doing are also included in the day-to-day tasks of the data scientist. Right, the first task we have for both jobs is reporting. So as a data analyst or a data scientist, you will be spending some of your time either creating reports or refreshing them or running them. In terms of time spent doing this now, you can see here that the data analyst is going to be spending most of his time doing reporting. However, the data scientist is not going to be spending a lot of time doing reporting. However, you still need to know how to do reporting if you want to be a data scientist. Now, in terms of the skills within reporting, you're going to need data gathering skills, data cleaning skills, transformational skills, data storing skills, and also technical knowledge on SQL, Excel, databases, and a visualization tool. So the idea of reporting is that you have some raw data from the business, this file for example, you take it into SQL where you put it in a table and then you clean it and you transform it so you can create a nice clean summary of that data. And then as soon as you have that clean summary, you can use your BI tool or Excel to communicate your results with the business. So over here, I have an example of a dashboard in Excel connected to SQL so we can push it into our stakeholders. And over here, I have an example of a Power BI dashboard connected to SQL again, where we can publish it and push it into our stakeholders. And as a data analyst, let's say, most of your time is going to be taking new raw data and refreshing these dashboards or these reports you have for the business. Moving on, the next task we have is analyzing the data for both roles. So after you finish with refreshing and managing your reports, you're going to be spending time looking at those reports and trying to analyze the numbers. In terms of the skills we need here is problem solving skills, as no solution will ever be the same, asking the right questions, critical thinking, and also fixing mistakes that you're going to be finding into these reports and into this data. An example here is in this Excel dashboard, let's say, after we refresh it, we can see that in March, we are not going to meet our target because it's red. And we can further investigate why. If we scroll down, we can see that it's the public sector who is lagging. And we can also see that the online products are the ones that are lagging significantly behind. Right, the next task we have is ad hoc analytics, which is over here and over here. Ad hoc now is usually a specific request that came on the back of a meeting or a presentation you had with the business. And also, ad hocs are usually a one-off and not a recurring thing. Now, the skills you need on both jobs to do these ad hoc analytics is problem-solving skills, as it's going to be a problem, say that gathering skills, as you're going to need to go and find the right data to answer those ad hoc questions, asking the right questions, and also time management, because usually an ad hoc is like an urgent request that the business needs immediately. In terms of how much time they take from each role, data analyst versus data scientist, if we go over here, we can see that mostly ad hoc analysis is done by data analysts and not data scientists. This is because ad hoc analyses are mostly easy questions that the data analyst can go in the database and query the database and get the answer, versus a more complex ad hoc that is usually going to get picked up by a data scientist. In terms of an example now, I have a few examples into SQL here. Some of the questions are, what is the total revenue of the company? What is the month over month revenue performance? What is the revenue versus target performance? And in terms of answering this, I have a few SQL queries here that show you exactly how to answer these basic questions. I'm going to have the link of this video in the description below. Moving on, the next task we have is automation of all processes, which is over here. So as an analyst, you will have to learn to work smart and not hard. The majority, if not all, of the reporting should be automated using all available tech stack. In terms of time that it takes from the two roles now, the automation of all processes, if we head over here, in the automating processes, we can see that most of it is done by data scientists, and then data analyst is right behind the data scientist. Now, what I mean for this automation is that I have an example over here in Python, for example. So here we have a model. This one is actually a machine learning one, but let's assume it's not a machine learning model. It's just some analysis in Python. What I do here is that instead of inputting the Excel file manually, I query the database. So I create a connection of SQL and Python in order to avoid doing this over and over again manually. So now each time I have new raw data in my database from either the analyst or the engineer, this script is going to fire itself and is going to generate new outputs, which are also going to be saved back in SQL over here. So I can then automate this process and not have to run it again every day or every week or every month. I also have another example in one of my YouTube videos where I show you how to create stored procedures into SQL. So let's say I have to run this question every month going forward. I can actually schedule it, run it, and auto-refresh it into Excel or Power BI so that I don't have to do this over and over again. Okay, so the next task or skill we have are the communication skills, which exist on both roles. So as a data analyst or a data scientist, you will have to communicate with the business. Some examples now is that you might have done some analysis and have to present it to the business, or you might need some data that is not in the database and you're going to have to go and talk to people in order to find that data, or you might have been tasked to help this X team, so the marketing team, for example, and analyze their performance. So you're going to have to go and sit down with the team and identify how you can support that team with data and analytics. In terms of the time it takes from the two roles, if we head over here, we can see that communication with stakeholders is mostly done by data scientists and not as much by the data analyst. Usually there is going to be a senior analyst or a product owner who is going to support the data analyst in order to do these comms with the business. However, as a data scientist, you need to be very comfortable in communicating data or ideas with the business. Right, the next task we have now are the machine learning models, which they do not exist into the data analyst job description. So this is one of the main differences between a data analyst and a data scientist. Now, the data scientists need to have machine learning knowledge. So models like linear regression, logistic regression, naive Bayes, supervised, unsupervised, and also time series analytics. They also need to have knowledge of Python or R so they can run their machine learning models. Statistics is also recommended and some advanced machine learning libraries for specific models. And just to show you an example about how this step works, here I have a Python script where I run my machine learning models. So I start by loading the raw data from SQL. So the data engineers or the data analysts are going to have the raw data saved into your database, into SQL. So an example is a table from distance. I pull the data into my Jupyter Notebook's Python script. Then I run my machine learning models. So here I have three models. I think I have a decision tree, a random forest, and XGBoost. Then when I'm happy with my model, I save the data back into SQL, into a new table, and then I connect SQL with a visualization tool. In this case, I use Power BI, which is this one, where I create my visuals, and then I publish my dashboard into the app, and I share the link with the wider business so they can come in here and view the results of my machine learning models. So here, I think I'm predicting the churns of a bank. So which customers are we predicting to churn and what can we do to avoid that churn and maintain those customers? Right, the next thing we have is critical thinking. And the reason we have critical thinking under data scientist and not data analyst is because the data scientist solution will need to be more critical, so more thoughtful, more sophisticated. And the idea is that the data scientists will need to challenge their own presuppositions or assumptions. So questions like, am I thinking this clear? Am I doing this right? Is there another way of doing it? A better way, a faster way, a more efficient way, a cheaper way? Do we have any hidden reasons why X is asking me this question? Should we investigate this further? So these questions are questions that the data scientists will need to challenge each time they are presented with a new scenario. And the last thing we have under data science is creativity. So as a data scientist, you will be presented with multiple scenarios that have no right or wrong answer or a guide to follow. So the data scientists will need to get creative on their solutions. So they can get creative on the type of model or type of software they use. They can get creative when designing new dashboards and visuals. They can get creative when it comes to including more data sources so you can get more statistics and analytics out of your results. You can get creative when you're presenting your insights by telling a story, or you can get creative by experimenting how to automate your work so you can make it to run faster or more efficient. Right, down here we also have the typical workflow of the data scientist, but we are not going to cover it in this video. What I've done now is that I've taken all these tasks and then I plotted them into Power BI so we can visually see the data scientist versus the data analyst. So down here, I also have the tasks from data engineers. Hence, I'm going to remove them quickly so we can compare data analyst and data scientist. So things like cloud solutions or data pipelines or data security, database management, dimensional modeling are things that the data engineer is doing. So now we have just data science and data analyst tasks. So clearly from this graph, we can see that data analysts are spending most of their time, let me make this bigger, doing reporting, ad hoc analytics, and analyzing the data. So you can see it over here. And then data scientists spend most of their time automating processes, communicating with stakeholders, which is similar with the presentation of results, machine learning, critical thinking, and creativity. And in terms of tools now, if we go down here into the technologies, again, I'm going to remove the engineering technologies, which is C, Java, Cloud, Clusters, and then Snowflake. So if we make this bigger, we can see that in terms of tools, both roles use pretty much the same tools, but it comes down to how much time you're using that tool or how much knowledge you have with that tool. So as you can see, data analyst is only winning in terms of using Excel, and the rest is mostly data scientist. But the tools are pretty much the same. It's just a question of knowledge and time spent using those tools. Right, this is it for this video, and I hope you've gained a very good understanding of the differences between a data analyst and a data scientist. So I see data science as a progression from data analytics, assuming the individual wants to learn more about statistics and machine learning, but it's really up to the individual if they want to learn more. And if you feel you've got enough value out of this video, please click that like button, subscribe to my channel, and enable notifications for my future videos. Until then, I hope I see you in the next video. Thank you.